Hey guys, I'm Chani and you're watching The Art of Science. If you're a subscriber, welcome back. And if not, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon so every time we release a new video, you get a notification. Today's video will discuss the two main types of electricity, static electricity and dynamic electricity. But before we do that, we must first understand the basics of what electricity is. The building blocks of everything around us are called atoms. These atoms are made up of three even smaller particles that carry different charges: the positively charged protons, negatively charged electrons, and the neutrally charged neutrons. While the neutron and the proton come together and stay at the center of the atom, the electrons spin around them, and some electrons can even flow out of the atom. This free movement of electrons is what causes electricity. Some materials allow electricity to flow easily, and these are called conductors, whereas some materials do not allow electricity to flow through them easily and are called insulators. Moving on to static and dynamic electricity. You must have done this or seen this experiment in school. When we rub a plastic scale or a rubber balloon on our heads, it starts attracting bits of paper. This is because of static electricity. When two objects are rubbed against each other, the free moving electrons jump from one object to the other. The object that loses electrons becomes positively charged, and the one that gains electrons becomes negatively charged. You can check out some fun and cool experiments with static electricity in the video that I've linked up here. Dynamic electricity is a steady flow of electrons. This flow occurs in a closed electrical circuit. This type of electricity is seen in household and commercial uses because this type of electricity can be controlled and regulated. Did you know that you can use dynamic electricity to make this awesome spy alert alarm and a bell? Check them out in the link above. In case of dynamic electricity, the flow of electrons is constantly maintained. However, to generate static electricity, we have to rub two objects against each other. Though easy, once the rubbing stops, the buildup of charge also stops and the static disperses back into the environment. This is an electroscope and it's another fun DIY related to static electricity that you can make at home. You can check it up here in the link above. Another difference between static and dynamic electricity is that for static electricity, we need two objects and at least one of them must be an insulator. However, dynamic electricity can only flow through conductors and not through insulators. If you want us to dig deeper in these topics and make more such videos, leave a comment below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next week!